Hello everyone and welcome to second Unity tutorial of how to make menu from different games. Today we will create menu from one of the best RPGs of all time, Skyrim. Our menu will eventually consist of the game logo on a black background, pack in front of it, a couple of buttons and a cursor. Compared to the previous tutorial, this one will be much easier, but anyway, I hope someone finds it useful. So, let's get started. Let's start with the camera. For the menu to have a solid black background in the back, set the clear flex value to solid color and set the color to black. Now let's get into the logo. After importing it into a project, set the texture type to sprite and mesh type to full rec, slightly increasing the pixel per unit. This way we will achieve good picture quality. After that, create a new image, insert the logo and press set native size. It turned out to be quite small, so we can slightly increase its scale to 8. And move it a little bit to the left. Excellent! Next, you need to surround the logo with fog, which can be obtained from the standard Unity assets. But if you don't need all the assets files, you can download it from the Google Drive using the link in the description. Move the prefab to the stage and move it to the camera. For more randomness and density of the fog, you can create one more and move it a little higher. But we want the fog to surround the logo and not be behind it. To do this, we need to change the render mode property of the canvas to world space, which will mean that the canvas will not just be a part of our UI interface, but will become a movable object. Then we reduce the scale to 0.0035 and move it into a fog. Now let's move on to music and sounds. In order for the music to play in our menu, create an empty object, name it music, hang audio source on it, and drag the music file. Also, set a loop flag so music will play endlessly. We will also create a separate object for the sound of the start of the game. Hang the audio source on it, but remove the play on the start flag. Next, we need to create the buttons themselves. Add a new canvas and create a text in it. Let's make it gray. Increase the size, apply a font to it, and shrink it a little so that it looks like the text from the Skyrim menu. You also need to write a ligand and move it to the bottom right corner. Also, apply a font material to it. Duplicate the text and create the rest of the buttons. Each next button with a smaller in the font size than the previous one. Looks good. But we want the text to turn white when we hover over the button. Let's do that. We need to create a script for controlling the menu buttons. We will hang all on buttons. Since we need to handle clicks, we connect the Unity engine.event system library and use three interfaces from there, two for handling hover and one for handling clicks. Also, to interact with UI components, we need to connect Unity engine.ui. Then we need two variables for the color, one for gray and one for white. Now, on hover, change the color to white and then to gray when the focus changes. Next, drag the script to all our buttons and specify the appropriate hover colors. Press play and see what happens. The buttons change this curve perfectly, but for some reason, the hover arrow is larger than their width. To fix this, you need to reduce the width of each button, so the text borders are at the end of the letters. We will also do the processing of clicks. For this, we will create a special type, yanam. It's useful for us to determine the type of the button. Let's add the values of our button there. Make a separate variables for it, and create a variable play sound, which will be responsible for playing the sound of the beginning of the game. Now, depending on the type of the button, its behavior will change. Clicking the new button will play the game start sound. Clicking quit will exit the game. And the rest of the buttons will output something to a console. Now, for each button, set the appropriate type and see what we got. As you can see, when you click on load on credits, output to the console occurs. When you click on the new, a sound is played. But when you click on quit, nothing happens. Don't worry. This only due to the fact that we are now in the editor, not in the game itself. The menu really looks good, but the system cursor is clearly out of the game style. Let's fix that. This step is the simplest of all we have done. First, go to the sprite settings and tell Unity that we are dealing with the cursor, and change the max size value. After which we need just to go to the game settings and put it there. Now, finally, we can see what we got. Great, we have finally created a Skyrim menu. Well, that's pretty much it for this video. Thank you for watching, and if you liked this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, where there will be many more interesting things. I will see you in the next video.